Hello students, rectifier is a circuit that is used for converting AC supply into DC supply. A controlled rectifier is a circuit that is used for converting AC supply into unidirectional DC supply and can control the output fed to the load. In ordinary rectifier using diodes, we can't control the output power fed to the load. By using controlled switch like SCR, we can control the output power fed to the load. Usually in controlled rectifier, silicon controlled rectifier SCR is used as a electronic switch because it can change AC into DC and at the same time it can control the amount of power fed to the load. Controlled rectifiers are mainly classified into two: single phase controlled rectifier and three phase controlled rectifier. Single phase controlled rectifier is again classified into single phase half wave controlled rectifier, single phase fully controlled bridge rectifier and single phase half controlled bridge rectifier. Similarly, three phase controlled rectifiers are again classified into three phase half wave controlled rectifier, three phase fully controlled converter or rectifier and three phase half controlled converter. Today we will discuss single phase half wave controlled rectifier with resistive load. Figure shows a single phase half wave controlled rectifier circuit with resistive load. Here only power circuit is shown, control circuit is not shown here. Supply voltage is Vs, which is equal to Vm sin omega t. SCR can conduct only when anode voltage is positive and a gate signal is applied. During the positive half cycle of the supply voltage, the SCR is forward biased. At some delay angle alpha, a positive gate signal is applied between gate and cathode. SCR is turned on. Immediately, full supply voltage is applied to the load as V0. And also, we know that for resistive load, the output current I0 is in phase with the output voltage V0. By varying the firing angle alpha, we can control the output voltage and thereby power supplied to the output. And also from 0 to alpha, SCR is in the off state and supply voltage appears across the SCR. At omega t is equal to pi, SCR is reverse biased and output current naturally goes to 0. So natural commutation occurs and the SCR is turned off. So during the negative half cycle, the SCR blocks the flow of current and no voltage is applied to the load. So source voltage appears across the SCR. From the waveform, it is clear that the supply voltage Vs is equal to V0 plus Vt. Next, we will find out the RMS and average value of output voltage V0 across the load R. The average value of output voltage V0 average is equal to area divided by base, which is equal to, so area is integral alpha to pi Vm sin omega t, integral alpha to pi Vm sin omega t into d omega t divided by, here base is 2 pi because the same wave repeated in 2 pi interval. So divided by 2 pi. So which is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral alpha to pi. So which is equal to Vm by 2 pi integral alpha to pi sine omega t into d omega t, which is equal to Vm divided by 2 pi integral of sine omega t, which is minus cos omega t with the limits alpha to pi, which is equal to Vm divided by 2 pi minus Vm divided by 2 pi cos pi minus cos alpha, which is equal to minus Vm divided by 2 pi. Cos pi is minus 1 minus cos alpha minus into this terms, which is equal to Vm by 2 pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Therefore, V0 average of single phase half wave controlled rectifier is equal to Vm by 2 pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Similarly, I0 average is equal to Im divided by 2 pi into 1 plus cos alpha, or which is equal to Vm by 2 pi into 1 plus cos alpha divided by R. Next is the RMS value. V0 RMS is equal to root mean square value. Therefore, V0 RMS is equal to area square divided by base root. That is root of area square divided by base, which is equal to integral alpha pi Vm square sine square omega t into d omega t divided by base 2 pi is equal to Vm divided by root 2 pi root of integral alpha to pi. Instead of sin square omega t, we can write 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2, because we know that sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. So instead of I square omega t, we can write 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2 into d omega t, which is equal to Vm by, we can take this 2 outside, therefore 2 root pi root of 1 minus cos 2 omega t into d omega t, which is equal to Vm divided by 2 root pi root of 1 into d omega, sorry, integral alpha to pi. Integral 1 into d omega t is omega t with the limits alpha to pi minus integration of cos 2 omega t into d omega t, which is sin 2 omega t by 2 with the limits alpha to pi, which is equal to Vm by 2 root pi root of pi minus alpha minus of sin 2 pi by 2 minus sine 2 alpha by 2. Sine 2 pi is 0. Therefore, Vm by 2 root pi root of pi minus alpha plus sine 2 alpha by 2. So, V0 RMS is equal to Vm by 2 root pi pi minus alpha plus sine 2 alpha by 2. Therefore, I0 RMS is equal to V0 RMS divided by R. Also, power P delivered to the resistive load is equal to VRMS into IRMS or VRMS square divided by R. Thank you.